Hello everybody, welcome to Fallout 4 Settlements number 5, and we're going to cover the areas we spoke about previously. We've got Greentop Nursery, and then we've got Coastal Cottage. Now, I've not done anything with Coastal Cottage yet, because I'm going to do a complete build through for this video. I'm going to clear it, everything, all in high speed for this video. But let's have a quick look around Greentop Nursery before we start with that, because it's very small and won't take us very long at all. Okay, to be honest, it's very similar to others, so I'm just going to whip round it. This is our entrance. Nicely covered, because it gets raided a lot, this place. Might not now I've put all my defences in, but
if you need fixing up
the hospital, which is, to be honest, it's pretty much exactly the same as the one in, what's it called? Mine's gone a blank. Sanctuary. It's pretty much exactly the same, just a little rougher. This is a little backwater place. Apart from that, there's no real difference. The walls go all the way around.
You hear about that farm run by ghouls? Isn't that something?
I want to keep this place looking like its original settlement to some degree.
Hope you ain't
so I kept all this greenhouse. And then I've got me stores at the end. Okay. And I use this side strip as my water production, just to keep it all neat and tidy.
Lost track of how many blisters.
Didn't bother with much in the way of workshops. I mean, this stuff was already here. And this is the main hub. Pretty much everything else is in here. We have the hotel. I built some little stores this time. Oh no. We've only got one toilet. Hey ho. There we go. This is like the main living area. And on the next floor,
you need something, monsieur.
This is like the governor's suite.
Crops been growing pretty good lately.
And then we have a whole view of the walls from here. Can get round the entire wall as before. Another settlement. Dogmeat's house, of course. Then up here we have the bar. Instead of a pool table, I put a boxing ring in the middle. VIP seating. Bar itself. Jukebox.
Farming's as honest work.
And then over here, the roof, I did a similar thing like I did at Outpost Zimonja, just because I like this look, it just looks cool. I think it's brilliant. Got little platforms with my rocket turrets on it. And you can look out over everything from here. And that's it. So I'm going to head over to Coastal Cottage, or Coastal Crossing, whatever it's called. And we'll start there. See you in a mo. Right, here we are. Coastal Crossing. To be brutally honest, this place is a complete dump. And I really, I don't even know where to begin. it is literally a pit. There's a little hole down here. I might try and do something interesting with that hole. Maybe a little dungeon or something. But, I mean, the settlement itself is actually quite large. Let's bring it up. I mean, it's a fair size. I mean, obviously I've got bigger, but I think what I'm going to do is just completely scrap the entire thing, starting from the ground up. I don't really know what to do with it, to be honest. If I wasn't doing this series, this is probably a settlement I would just leave alone. I mean, it's out in the middle of nowhere, right on the edge of the map. And it's a tip. Okay, gonna start clearing. Okay, so that's it cleared. That took me roughly 20 minutes to do. I kept some of the intact parts. If I'm honest, there are a few bushes that are a bit tricky to get their scrap option. Like this thing over here, you probably saw me milling around it a little bit. But as I build, these sort of things tend to just pop up randomly once in a while. And I can grab them then. But yeah, I've kept a couple of parts just for the just to keep some of the original look of the place. Now I'll start building. See that? There we go. Yeah, I'll start getting building. And we'll do that in speed as well. I'm going to record the whole building process for this one. Alright, catch you in a moment. So I've got the main build finished. Now I've just got to decorate all the insides and what have you. So see you in a few minutes for a walk around. Hello everybody. Right, so here we are, we're ready for our final walk around. Now, the theme I've sort of gone for with this is, as you can see, that big tower there is lit up. I've kind of made it like a kind of lighthouse fortress, because we're right on the coast. So let's go for a walk around. So we walk up the road here, and this is the main path up onto the settlement. Got our entryway there. I did want to put gates in, but as you might have seen in the speed up version, I just couldn't get it to fit in because of the slam. Come up, okay, into the main courtyard, and we go over here. Now, this is a military style encampment, so I've only got guns and armour. I haven't got traders in there yet. I've only got a couple of settlers so far. This is the workshop. Now, originally, I tried to put workbenches in here, but this floor, I had the same problem with as I did on the big screen at the drive-in. Stuff were either sunk into the floor or floating, and would have looked dumb, so it's still clear. Okay. Most of that house I got rid of and just kept the front porch bit, just to keep it looking aesthetically pleasing. Just looks nice. Okay. Dog meets house. And then if we go into the main pub, we have here the hospital. Quite nice and large. And loose. And on that side. Yes, I remembered to put a toilet in both this time. Main office. And then over here we've got the barber's corner.
Out here, you gotta take things one day at a time.
Thanks for that. Then, if we go upstairs, we have a bar. Again, it's all a military theme, so I didn't want to overdo it with things. It's just like a soldier's bar. A jukebox in the corner. And then up here, I've done a kind of platform farm this time. So the farm is on the top of the settlement. All our food production. The outdoor barbecue area. Okay. And then we've got the walls. Now, over here, like I've already said, I did a kind of fortress theme. Just jump down. Right, this is the main entrance tower. Up here, and this is the mess hall for soldiers. And then up here, we have our first watch over the door. I haven't got any soldiers guarding it yet, but it's only just been built, so it's got its own independent power source for the tower. And if we go up here, we've got bunks and that for soldiers in this tower. Very straightforward. And up here we've got our second watch. Just a higher view. See, I could have put a lighthouse like that into the settlement through one of the mods I've got, but if I'd have put the lighthouse down, it would have taken up most of the room of this settlement and would have been hard to build around, so I decided to build one, which we'll go to last. Got some more soldiers' quarters with a little administration area, and then we're up onto the roof.
can see for miles. You can see out for miles. As you can see, my lighthouse is quite well lit up. Again, I use these because they just look so cool. So that's the tower number one. Okay. And then tower number two. I would have ideally liked to have put four towers onto this settlement so it was like an old style castle, but unfortunately where those rocks are made it very difficult to make it even, so I ended up with three towers. In this tower we've got our weapons workshops, an armor workshop, our armor workshop. So this would be the workshop area. More soldiers quarters for this tower, and again more soldiers quarters for this tower. And then on the roof we've got our laser turrets. Now while I was building this this area, I did get in a little scrap with a deathclaw to fight it off. By the time I killed it, of course, we're down there somewhere. Again, I put the towers on the top, so it's got its, all the turrets and lights up here are powered by these wind turbines. I like it, it's cool. And that just leaves the tower itself, the lighthouse. So we've got like an intelligence area here, and this is primarily for one person to live, the lighthouse keeper. And he's like our intelligence man. So we've got his little bits and bobs down the bottom here. And then we've got his own personal quarters, this is his lounge. I was going to put a TV and what have you in here, but there just wasn't much room. It's quite sparsely decorated. And then up here we've got his living quarters, his bedroom in there. And then he has his little administration area, his desk, filing cabinets. And then we're up to the lighthouse itself. And that's quite bright up here. I put up a lot of street lamps. And this big dome light is giving off a hell of a lot of light, although the dome itself doesn't look lit up. Quite visible. Can't have everything from the mod. This is the lighthouse. And then I've done the flags in various places as well, just to make it look a bit cooler. So there you go. This is Coastal Cottage. Oh, yes, actually. There was one bit I wanted to show you. When I did my first walk around, I said I was going to turn that hole into a little dungeon. Well, I've done the best I can. But I think you'll like what I've done. Because it was a very small hole. And it was quite difficult to get done. So anyway, I've got this kind of old castle looking door, and that's the best way I could fit it. I couldn't get it any better. Thank you, Dogmeat. And then in here we've got a couple of cages, and then down here we've got the interrogation cave. Originally I turned that cave into a bit of a prison cell, but it just looked stupid, so I built this using a mod. And this is the dungeon. Put down a couple of meat sacks just to make it look a bit gorier. I left the tools and things, got the cigars there for the torturer to chomp away on. I don't know why that's there, because they're not here to be healed. And I put some coffins in as well. Just the darker side of the castle. Yeah. So there you go. Please comment, like, subscribe, leave me your comments. And incidentally, this video has taken me a month to compile, mainly because I run out of materials, and I spent a hell of a lot of time regathering materials, particularly bottle caps, so that I can get it built. And then, of course, actually building it probably took me, in total, roughly 8 hours in gameplay. But the main problem was I had to gather supplies. Now, what I want from you guys is to let me know, should I continue to gather materials and build as best I can using what I find, or shall I use console commands and just top up my supplies that way? Let me know what you think. Because I know some people will only go, oh, you're just zapping the supplies, that's cheating. And yes, you're right, it is, it's cheating. But, for the sake of speed, do you want me to do that so I can roll these videos out a bit quicker? Okay, well, thanks for watching, let me know your comments, and let me know what you think. Basically, if more people say, gather the supplies, I'll gather, and if more people say, use the console commands, I'll use the console commands. Okay, well, thanks for watching. Our next stop will be the slog, which I've already started, but it's still in its very basic state yet. I'm going to do a kind of hotel look for that, with the ground floor being the swimming pool. I'm going to do it as a kind of hotel. So I'm going to make that one look very civilian, very like a nice place you'd like to visit in Apocalypse. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye for now.